Welcome back everyone. Today in this video we are going to talk about computer fundamentals. Computers have become an integral part of our daily routine life in these days. There is hardly any field which is untouched from computer technology, whether it is education, business, healthcare, entertainment or communication. The computer available nowadays is process billions of instructions in a per second. So in this chapter we are going to talk about computer and the processing of data in it. So let's start.
As you all know, computer is an electronic data processing machine. In its raw form, data input along with the instruction processes it electronically and gives the useful information. Okay, here we have two words with a similar meaning but different alphabets, that is raw data and information. Let's take one example, but before example let me tell you what is this data. Computer processes the raw information as per the instruction given to it. The raw information which do not make any sense in itself is called data. Information. The data is processed by the computer as per the instructions to give as the required output called information. Let's take example. Suppose you have given one problem to computer, that is 6 plus 6. So 6 plus 6, when you entered these digits along with the mathematical operation in the computer, the process will be done in the CPU. After processing it, CPU will give the answer to the output. The output we will get will be 12 through the output device. So 6 plus 6 is a raw data, and the output we got from CPU, that is 12, is a information. Now let's move forward. Next is computer components. Computer has two main components, that is hardware and software. Those part of computer which we can see or touch or feel, example, you can see here. Here are parts of computer which we can see. See here on the screen. LCD monitor, laptop, computer system, keyboard, speaker, headphone, wireless router, graphic card, sound card. So all these parts of computer which we can touch are called hardware. Now software. Those part of computer which we can't see or touch are called software. As you can see on the screen, examples are given here. Windows, iOS, Linux, Windows XP, iOS, Android, etc. All these are software. We cannot touch it, even not we can see. Let's move forward. Now hardware. Hardware can be divided into four components, that is input device, central processing unit, output device, and storage device or backing storage device. So next topic will be IPO cycle. But first, let me tell you what is IPO. Here, I means input device or input, P means process, and O means output. Now, next problem is, what is input device? You might have learned in your previous classes, but let me tell you it again. Input device, hardware devices which are connected with the computer to give data and instruction to the computer are called input device. Right? Again, let me tell you, those hardware devices which are connected with computer to give data or instruction to the computer, they are known as input device. You can see your example, keyboard, mouse, scanner, UPC reader, microphone. These all are part of computer which externally connected and used to give command or instruction to the computer. So next is output device. Output device are those devices which used to give output or the information to the user. Let's take example. Examples are window display, printer, speakers, slide projector and plotter. These are the examples of output. Not only these, we are having so many things in example of output. Now the next is storage device. Storage device. Storage devices are used for storing the information permanently inside the computer. These are those devices which are used to store the information. So, let's take example. Magnetic disk, optical disk, magnetic tape, pen drive, compact disk, DVD, hard disk. So, these all are the example of storage device, in which we can store a data by permanently or temporary. Next is processing device, that is CPU. As we know, computer has a very large memory to store the information. A memory is just like a human brain. It is used to store data and instruction. Computer memory is the storage space in the computer, where data is to be processed and instructions required for processing are stored. Computer memory is basically of two type. First is primary memory. It includes example RAM and ROM. Second is secondary memory. It includes example like hard disk, floppy disk and CD. So now let's talk about the primary memory. As you can see on the screen, there are RAM and ROM. These two looks like a chip, and these are installed in the CPU. Let's move forward. Secondary memory. If we need to store large amount of data or program permanently, we need a cheaper or permanent memory, such as a secondary memory. Here, again, secondary memory is divided into two parts. First is fixed devices. Second is removable device. Fixed device example include like hard disk drive, CD, DVD drive. Whereas the removable devices like pen drive, Blu-ray disc. Now, we will compare primary memory, that is RAM and ROM. On the basic is RAM, it is a read and write memory. ROM, it is read only memory. It used to store the data that has to be currently processed by CPU temporarily. and ROM. It stores the instruction required during bootstrap of computer. Bootstrap means to restart a computer. Now, volatility. It is a volatile memory. ROM. ROM is a non-volatile memory. Volatile means where you can retrieve the information, you can reuse or recognize the information. Now, standards for what is RAM? RAM is a random access memory, whereas ROM is a read-only memory. Now, modification, data in RAM can be modified. We can change the data in RAM. Whereas in ROM, we cannot modify the data which we already saved. Now about the capacity. RAM size is from 64 MB to 4 GB. This is the limit of RAM. Now ROM. ROM is comparatively smaller than RAM. ROM is a smaller than RAM. Now the cost. RAM is a costlier memory. RAM is very expensive. Now ROM. ROM is comparatively cheaper than RAM. ROM is cheap, means it is lesser in price. Now type. Types of RAM are static RAM and dynamic RAM. RAM is the two type, that is original RAM and a dynamic RAM. Whereas the ROM having different types like ROM, PROM, EPROM and EEPROM. Now, we will study about the kind of memory, electronic memory, that is cache memory. Cache memory. It is used for storing the input which is given by the user and which is necessary for computer microprocessor to perform a task. It is a high-speed temporary electronic memory where the most recently or more frequently used data are stored to avoid the reload from a slower storage medium. It is used to enhance the performance of CPU. It is important for CPU. Okay, now the next is, why is cache memory is needed? What is the reason behind using cache memory? A small but fast cache memory in which the content of the most commonly accessed locations are maintained can be placed between the CPU and the main memory. When a program executes, the cache memory is searched for. As you can see here in the block diagram, where the CPU is processing with any instruction and the cache memory is storing those things which are frequently used by the user, and whereas the memory part is storing the memory what has been done by the input and output. Now the next is memory presentation. Memory representation, it is an integral storage area in a computer which is availed to store data and program either permanently or temporary. Computer memory is broadly divided into two groups that we have already studied, that is primary memory and secondary memory. When the main memory holds the instructions and data, when a program is executing, the auxiliary memory or secondary memory holds the data and program which is not currently in use and furnishes long-term storage. When the main memory holds instructions and data, when a program is executing, main memory holds main memory, that is primary memory, holds all the instructions and data, whereas the auxiliary memory or secondary memory holds data and program which is not currently in use and furnishes for long time period or long term storage. Next is, the primary memory and a secondary memory are further classified into distinct groups, and those are explained below in the form of diagram. Here, memory is divided into two parts, that is primary and secondary. And again, primary memory is divided into two parts, that is RAM and ROM. Whereas the secondary memory is again divided into four parts, that is magnetic tape, magnetic disc, optical disc, USB flash drive, mass storage drive. So, these about storage memory you are going to learn further in the senior classes. Right now you have just learned about the RAM and ROM, which is very important in your class. Next is computer unit. Memory unit is the amount of data that can be stored in the storage unit. This storage capacity is expressed in the term of bytes, where we store the data in our computer. That data is measured in the unit of byte. The following point explain the main memory storage units. So, one bit is, that is bit is known as, bit is the short form, whereas the full form of bit is binary digit. A binary digit is logically 0 and 1. 0 and 1 representing a passive or an active state of the component in an electric circuit. Now, 2 nibble. 2 nibble is a group of 4 bits, is called a nibble. Now, 3 byte. A group of 8 bits is called byte. A byte is the smallest unit which can represent a data in term of a character or item. Now, the next is 4 word. A computer word like a byte is a group of fixed number of byte processed as the unit, which varies the computer to computer but is fixed for each computer. The length of the computer word is called word size or word length. It may be as small as bit or may be as long as 96 bit. A computer stores the information in the form of computer words. Here you can see memory measurement units. 1 kilobyte is equal to 1024 bytes, and 1 megabyte is equal to 1024 kilobytes. 1 gigabyte is equal to 1024 megabyte. 1 tetrabyte is equal to 1024 gigabyte, and 1 petabyte is equal to 1024 petabytes. 1 exabyte is equal to 1024 petabytes, and 1 zettabyte is equal to 1024 exabytes. 1 yottabyte is equal to 1024 zettabyte. This is a very important chart for upcoming further studies of memory in senior classes. Now, as you can see on the screen, how the computer is converting single word, that is hello, into a binary digit. These all process, converting digit, converting alphabet into a binary digit, it all take process in a computer brain. You can see here, computer is converting a single alphabet into how many digit. Okay, so this way computer used to store the memory in the form of 2 digit, that is 0 and 1, and that is also known as binary digit. Here you can see The full form of ASII, that is American Standard Code of Information Exchange.
That's all for today. We will see in the next lecture with a new topic. Till then, take care.